Nitrates and phosphates, whenever are applied to the agriculture fields, they do pollution either way. One way, if they will enter the water bodies, surface water bodies, they will call eutrophication. Okay, you know that. They will cause eutrophication. And whenever there is, you know, excess drainage, excess irrigation, okay, and water is not allowed to run off from there. So what will happen? The nitrate present in the water may leach down. Kyun leach down karega, guys? Because nitrate has negative charge over it. Kya hota hai? Nitrate has negative charge over it, NO3, negative. So actually, soil has high cation exchange capacity. Cation exchange means generally negative ions are present on soil, especially clay minerals, right? So what they do, they hold the positive ions, which are known as cations. Okay? But it is very difficult for example, ammonium ion, which is NH4 positive, right? Ammonium ion will not get leached. Why? Because it will be holded by the anions present in the soil. But in case if there is some anion, just like nitrate is an anion. So this can leach down if excess irrigation is being done. So, and right, in agriculture field, so this nitrate can leach down and can contaminate the groundwater. Got it, guys? It can contaminate the groundwater. This is what happens. So now what is the problem? Like, why are we worried about the nitrate pollution? Now, if nitrate will pollute or reach the groundwater, what will happen? Actually, it will not be problematic for us, adults like us. But this nitrate content in drinking water, if this will reach our body, it's not problematic for us. But if infants will consume this nitrate polluted water, this will be a bit problem for them. Kya problem hoga? Generally, hamara, you know, guys, an adult stomach is having a very low pH. Our stomach is acidic in nature because there are a number of gastric juices which have been, released there. And our stomach has enough capacity to kuch bhi hum digest kar lete, right? Even meat can be easily digested. But what happens with the, you know, generally the pH of the stomach is 1.2 scale. 1 to 2 hoti hai, 1.2 ke around hoti hai, ya 1 to 2 less than that. Theek hai? So it is highly acidic, anything can be digested. But what happens? Ritambara, can you please mute your mic because I am muting you. I'm trying to mute all of you again and again. Ritambara, let me see. LMNOPQR. Who is this Oppo F1S? Please name yourself. Oppo, if my screen would be visible to you guys, who is this Oppo F1S? Please tell me your name. If you are on trial, please tell me your name. Pitambara, Ritambara, PQR. Ritambara ka mute ho gaya, I guess. Haan, haan, yeah, yeah, I have seen you. Yeah, yeah, you have been muted. Okay, so koi nahi, it happens initially. Guys, I'm also trying to mute. Agar nahi hota hai, toh baat alag hai. And Oppo, please tell me your name. Whoever is by the name Oppo F1S, please tell me your name. Let's not waste the time, guys.
Hello.
Huh? Yes.
Yeah, my name is Tanvi and I've changed it right now.
Okay, okay, fine. You are on trial.
Actually, I was taking offline classes, but today I'm trying the online one for the first time.
Okay, okay, fine, fine. You take the class. Okay, so guys, basically, kya hota hai? You know that the pH of our stomach is highly acidic, but it is not the case with the infants, right? The infants' ka GI tract jo hota hai, that is alkaline in nature, right? So basically, our stomach has very low pH and it is highly acidic. So in very high, you know, acidity, kibriya connect ho raha hai, sabka to connect ho gaya na, same se. Mera mute bol. So the GI tract, gastrointestinal tract of the infant is alkaline. So a few bacteria can, you know, grow there. There is a bacteria jo kya karta hai? Because in adults, because it is highly acidic, no bacteria can survive there. Hamari lower gut mein hota hai, right? Bacteria, but hamare upar nahi ho sakta koi. Ab isme kya hota hai? Basically, because of the alkaline tract, the bacteria which is living there in the GI tract of the infants, what it does, when the water contaminated or polluted with nitrate, right? When the nitrate contaminated water reaches their body, what it does, बहुत गलत लिखा है इसमें, आप इसको मत पढ़िए, मैं इसमें ना थोड़ा टाइपिंग एरर है, ठीक है? Let me read what is it. Nitrite oxidizes hemoglobin. Okay. इसमें लैंग्वेज थोड़ी वो डिफिकल्ट लिखी हुई है. इट इज लाइक व्हाट हैपेंस गाइस, द बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट देयर, व्हाट इट डज, दैट बैक्टीरिया एक्चुअली क्या करता है, जो नाइट्रेट व्हिच हैज रीच्ड द बॉडी ऑफ द इन्फेंट्स, ठीक है, द नाइट्रेट हैज रीच्ड देयर द बॉडी ऑफ द इन्फेंट्स. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, दैट बैक्टीरिया विल एक्चुअली कन्वर्ट नाइट्रेट इनटू नाइट्राइट, ठीक है. व्हाट हैपेंस, it converts this nitrate into nitrite. NO3 negative will get converted into NO2 negative. समझ में आ रहा है? Nitrate जब तक था फिर भी problematic नहीं था, but because that bacteria was present, it converted it into nitrite and NO2 negative कर दिया. अब what happens, this nitrite is actually it has more affinity towards the hemoglobin. Right. So what it does, this nitrite oxidizes the hemoglobin. It will get to hemoglobin ko pass. Ab simple si baat hai. Like if you have some of your friend and if you go somewhere, so always you will get attracted to the person whom you have more affinity towards. Hai na? Similar thing happens with it. Hemoglobin has more affinity. So kya hota hai? Hemoglobin. This nitrite oxidizes hemoglobin. Right. And it forms methemoglobin. So nitrate was not problematic, but when nitrate has been converted by bacteria living in the gut of infants, it has converted into nitrite. Now this nitrite will be get attached to hemoglobin. Hemoglobin ka kaam kya hota hai guys? The work of hemoglobin is to carry oxygen to the blood, body parts, various body parts, right? So what will happen, isko oxygen ke sath connect hona chahiye, but ये ना होके व्हाट विल इट डज, इट विल गेट अटैच टू नाइट्राइट और ये क्या बना लेगा, इट फॉर्म्स मिथ हीमोग्लोबिन. व्हाट इट फॉर्म्स मिथ हीमोग्लोबिन, मिथ एचबी. सो नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, बिकॉज इन प्लेस ऑफ ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड, जो हीमोग्लोबिन व्हेन व्हिच वाज सपोज टू गेट अटैच टू द ऑक्सीजन, इट हैज गॉट अटैच टू द नाइट्राइट फॉर्मिंग द मिथ हीमोग्लोबिन. This, because of this, the oxygen level of the body will decrease, hai na? When hemoglobin will not be available to get attached to the oxygen, so this will lead to the scarcity of oxygen in the body of the child. So this leads to the death of infants because of lack of oxygen. Theek hai? Lack of oxygen ki wajah se kya hota hai? The child dies or infants die, right? So this disease, and because of aapko, and you know guys, you are all science graduates, post graduates, wherever there is oxygen doesn't reaches to some body part, it turns blue, hai na, bluish ho jata hai. So because of the scarcity of oxygen, when the child is dying, so because of the lack of oxygen, the body of the child turns cyanish, cyan color ki ho jati hai, bluish. That is why this, you know, disease after the death, the blue will the body of the child will become bluish or cyanish. Isiliye isko bola jata hai blue baby syndrome. That's why we call this disease as blue baby syndrome, or this is also known as cyanosis. Kya bolte hain? This is also known as cyanosis. Clear? Any doubt here? Isse bolenge cyanosis, or it is known as ब्लू बेबी सिंड्रोम. और एक और नाम है, बिकॉज मिथ हीमोग्लोबिन इज फाउंड इज बींग फॉर्म्ड हियर, ठीक है. सो इट इज नोन एज मेथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया. देखो मेथ हीमोग्लोबिन बोलते हैं, मेथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया नहीं बोलते हैं. इट इज नोन एज मेथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया. देखो एनीमिया इज लैक ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन, राइट. और यहाँ पे मेथ हीमोग्लोबिन बन रहा है, दैट्स व्हाई ऐसे. इट इज जस्ट अ टेक्निक टू रिमेम्बर इट, डोंट वरी. ठीक है. अब यहाँ पे क्या होता है, मेथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया बन जाता है बिकॉज ऑफ बीमारी को बोलते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेथ हीमोग्लोबिन, राइट. क्लियर. सो इसीलिए हम इसको मेथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया बोलते हैं. एंड देयर इज वन मोर नेम टू दिस डिजीज, साइनोसिस, और द अदर नेम फॉर दिस डिजीज इज ब्लू बेबी सिंड्रोम. द क्वेश्चन दैट कम्स इन द एग्जाम इज विच डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाय नाइट्रेट पोल्यूशन, और ब्लू बेबी सिंड्रोम इज कॉज्ड बाय विच ऑफ द पोल्यूटेंट. ठीक है. एंड विच इज द, सो बेसिकली गाइज रिमेंबर, नाइट्रेट पोल्यूशन जनरली इज अ ग्राउंड वाटर प्रॉब्लम, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव स्टडीड इट इन ग्राउंड वाटर. ठीक है. अच्छा एक और चीज मैं आपको पूछना चाहती हूँ, डू यू नो, पुराने बच्चों को शायद पता होगा, इफ चार्ज इन सॉइल इज आल्सो हैविंग द नेगेटिव चार्ज, सॉइल इज हैविंग स्पेशली क्ले और ह्यूमस हैव अ हाई कैटायन एक्सचेंज कैपेसिटी बिकॉज़ दे हैव नेगेटिव चार्ज ओवर इट. ठीक है. दैट्स व्हाई इट विल बी हाईली मोबाइल एज कंपेयर टू द अमोनियम. अमोनियम आयन विल नॉट बी मोबाइल, राइट. नाइट्राइट, नाइट्रेट विल बी मोर मोबाइल इन नेचर. ठीक है. इसके अलावा आर्सेनिक पोल्यूशन हम पहले भी पढ़ चुके हैं गाइज, इफ यू रिमेम्बर, इन हैवी मेटल्स. आर्सेनिक इज ऑल्सो अ ग्राउंड वाटर पोल्यूशन प्रॉब्लम, राइट. एंड विच इज कॉज्ड बाय आर्सेनिक रिच मिनरल्स ऑफ होलोसीन पीरियड, राइट. आर्सेनिक रिच सेडिमेंट्स जब होते हैं, दिस कॉजेज रिडक्टिव डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ आर्सेनिक. आर्सेनेट से इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड टू आर्सेनाइट. ठीक है. व्हेन इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड टू आर्सेनाइट, व्हाट विल इट कॉज? इट विल कॉज Blackfoot disease. ठीक है. This is also a groundwater problem. Remember, there is one more groundwater problem which is known as salt water intrusion. क्या बोलते हैं इसको? Salt water intrusion. Clear है किसी को? Any doubt anyone? मिथ हीमोग्लोबिनीमिया clear? Okay, let's move. So what happens with the salt water intrusion? See, salt water intrusion occurs majorly at the coastal areas. Coastal areas where the level of the salt water is very near to the groundwater, right? So there is high chances of the intrusion of salt water into the column of the fresh water. Kyun hota hai reason? Asbestosis is caused by asbestos dust. Okay, but it is not the longest. Okay, so salt water intrusion kya hota hai guys? See, for example, this is sea. Ye sea hai. सी के पास क्या होता है? सी वॉटर, देयर इज कंटिन्यूस सॉल्ट वाटर इंट्रूजन ऑन द लैंड. सो एंड बेसिकली इट हैपेंस अंटिल देयर इज नो ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर, द प्रॉब्लम विल नॉट अकर. बट व्हेनेवर देयर विल बी ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ द ग्राउंड वाटर एट द कोस्टल एरियाज, दिस सॉल्ट वाटर इंट्रूजन प्रॉब्लम माइट अकर. ठीक है. सो यहाँ पे क्या होता है? हाँ, सो एक्चुअली व्हाई द प्रॉब्लम अकर्स, बिकॉज गाइज कैन यू टेल मी द डेंसिटी ऑफ फ्रेश वाटर इज मोर और द डेंसिटी ऑफ डेंसिटी ऑफ फ्रेश वाटर और सॉल्ट वाटर विच विल बी हायर? हाँ, सॉल्ट वाटर विल बी हायर, राइट. द डेंसिटी ऑफ सॉल्ट वाटर इज हायर देन द फ्रेश वाटर. सो डेफिनेटली जिसकी ज्यादा डेंसिटी होती है, सो द प्रेशर विल बी क्रिएटेड बाय ग्राउंड वाटर एक्सट्रैक्शन, हेंस बैंड इन मुंबई कोस्टल एरियाज, हाँ, ऑफ 500 मीटर्स. दैट्स व्हाई, बिकॉज़ यू नो, दिस क्रिएट्स द प्रॉब्लम. व्हाट हैपेंस, जो फ्रेश वाटर होता है, और वी कैन से दैट द सॉल्ट वाटर एक्चुअली हैव इज 2.5% मोर डेंसर देन द फ्रेश वाटर. ठीक है. द डेंसिटी ऑफ द सॉल्ट वाटर इज 2.5% हायर देन द फ्रेश वाटर. सो एक्चुअली व्हाट हैपेंस, द इफ फॉर एग्जांपल इफ द लेवल ऑफ वाटर, फ्रेश वाटर, ठीक है, एंड द लेवल ऑफ सॉल्ट वाटर इज एट द सेम लेवल. ठीक है. अरे यार, द सॉल्ट वाटर एंड द फ्रेश वाटर लेवल इज एट द सेम लेवल, तो क्या हो जाएगा? द सॉल्ट वाटर कैन इजिली बी एक्सट्रैक्टेड. बोलो एक्चुअली क्या होगा, जब हम जैसे दो, इफ वी हैव taken salt water and fresh water columns. This is present inside the ground. This is the salt water. And this is the fresh water column. So it will try to pump out water from here. So actually, because the salt water is denser, it will get extracted before the fresh water. Why? Because it is having high density. Jisme high density hoti hai, it exerts more pressure. So it will be easily extracted. To kya hota hai basically, whenever, ab generally kya hota hai, isiliye bilkul, and because just nearby the coastal areas, because they're higher, the closer we are to the coastal areas, higher the chances of the inundation or contamination or intrusion of the salt water into the fresh water column. Aisa kyun hota hai? Kyunki iski density zyada hoti hai. To agar hum even fresh water ko kabhi, if we will even try to extract the fresh water, this salt water will come and it will intrude the fresh water column. Or when it will intrude the fresh water column, it will contaminate whole of the water aquifer. ठीक है, इसीलिए ये problem आती है. Why if the ठीक है, so because there is a difference in the densities of fresh water and salt water. The fresh water is 2.5% less denser as compared to the salt water. So whenever we do, generally we have salt water. Generally भी क्या होता है आपको पता है? ये आपको मैंने नहीं बताया था. Let's revise it. That whenever there is a fresh water aquifer, generally ऊपर क्या होता है, दिस इज फ्रेश वॉटर. एट द बेस ऑफ द एक्वेफर जनरली वी हैव सॉल्ट्स, बिकॉज सॉल्ट वॉटर इज ऑलवेज डेंसर, सो इट विल बी लोअर देन द फ्रेश वॉटर. सो इट इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज अ सिम्टम इफ आई वॉज आई वॉज हैविंग अ बोरिंग एट सम प्लेस फॉर एग्जाम्पल. ठीक है, सो इनिशियली आई वॉज गेटिंग अ फ्रेश वॉटर आउट ऑफ इट, बट यू नो आफ्टर सम टाइम और विदाउट एनी रीजन आई स्टार्टेड टू गेट salt water from an aquifer. This is also an indication that my aquifer is going to deplete. Why? Because salt water will always at the base of a fresh water aquifer, because salt water is higher in density than the fresh water. ठीक है, तो अगर आपके फ्रेश वाटर के एक्वेफर में अचानक से बोरिंग से सॉल्ट वाटर आने लगा, दिस माइट बी एन इंडिकेशन दैट माय एक्वेफर इज गोना डिप्लीट. ठीक है, इट इज गोइंग टू रीच इट्स मैक्सिमम लेवल. तो क्या होता है जनरली, बिकॉज माय फ्रेश वाटर इज 2.5% लेस देन एज कंपेयर टू द सॉल्ट वाटर, तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है, इफ वी विल, तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इसकी अगर 40 फीट पे इफ वॉटर फ्रेश वॉटर इज प्रेजेंट एट 40 फीट डेप्थ. ठीक है, सो इट विल एक्सर्ट सेम प्रेशर एज विल बी एक्सर्टेड बाय सॉल्ट वॉटर कॉलम एट द डेप्थ ऑफ 41 फीट. 41 फीट जो है, 41 फीट मतलब अगर वो 41 फीट से ज्यादा डीप होगा सॉल्ट वॉटर का कॉलम, देन ओनली इट विल बी safer to extract water, ठीक है, from ground. मतलब basically क्या होता है, ground water intrusion होता है, salt water intrusion because of over exploitation of water. ठीक है, if my if the depth of my water table is much very good, ठीक है, and it should be at least more than the minimum difference between a fresh water column and the salt water column should be 25%. 25% का difference होना चाहिए. जैसे ही इट्स डिफरेंस ऑफ द फ्रेश वॉटर एंड द सॉल्ट वॉटर कॉलम विल डिमिनिश, द सॉल्ट वॉटर विल इंक्लूड माई फ्रेश वॉटर कॉलम. ठीक है, तो जनरली इफ वी हैव नॉट ओवर एक्सप्लॉइटेड द ग्राउंड वॉटर, इट विल नॉट कंटामिनेट, देर विल बी नो सॉल्ट वॉटर इंक्लूजन प्रॉब्लम. लेकिन जैसे ही देर विल बी ओवर एक्सप्लॉइटेशन, मीन्स इफ वी विल डिमिनिश और इफ वी विल रिमूव, ठीक है, ये 2.5% का डिफरेंस जो है फ्रेश वॉटर के कॉलम में और सॉल्ट वॉटर के कॉलम में, so as soon as this will disappear, the fresh salt water will try to intrude the fresh water column. ठीक है, this is the problem that occurs. मतलब क्या करना है हमें, if at some place the depth of the salt water column is 41 feet, तो हम उस aquifer से, उसके पास वाले aquifer से, fresh water aquifer से 40 फीट से ज्यादा एक्सट्रैक्शन नहीं करेंगे. अगर वो 40 फीट पहुंच गया, मान लो पहले वो 20 फीट था, राइट, वी केप्ट ऑन टेकिंग वाटर आउट ऑफ इट, लेते रहे. नाउ द वॉटर हैज बिकम 40 फीट और इन द फ्रेश वाटर कॉलम, तब तक वो सेफ है. एज सुन एज इट विल गो डाउन फर्दर, नाउ एज सुन एज दिस डिफरेंस ऑफ 2.5% विल डिसअपीयर, जो तुम्हारा मेरा ये जो पानी है इसमें ये इंक्लूड कर जाएगा और मेरा होल फ्रेश वाटर एक्वेफर विल बिकम सॉल्ट वाटर. ठीक है, दिस इज द केस विद इट. क्लियर है गाइज? किसी को कोई डाउट? इससे अदरवाइज कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता. बेसिक प्रॉब्लम इज बिकॉज ऑफ ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर इन द कोस्टल एरियाज, सॉल्ट वाटर इंट्रूजन अकर्स. क्लियर है या प्रॉब्लम है? प्लीज टेल मी. सो इट इज ओनली द ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन प्रॉब्लम. शैल वी मूव फर्दर? समझ में आया या नहीं आया? ओके, लेट्स मूव फर्दर. यहाँ पे आपका क्लियर हो गया ग्राउंड वाटर. ठीक है, ग्राउंड वाटर पोल्यूशन इज कंप्लीट हियर. नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. सो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक हियर इज, सो अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एसिड रेन. Acid rain is also a type of air pollution and it is a secondary pollutant. There are two types of pollutants in case of air pollution, right? One is primary, the other one is secondary pollutant. So what are secondary pollutants? Secondary pollutants are the pollutants which do not have definite source. They arise as a result of reaction between the primary pollutants. ठीक है, अब primary pollutants कौन से होते हैं? Which have a definite source, which have some source from where they are emitted from the environment, in the environment. But secondary pollutants do not have any definite source. They arise as a result of reaction between the primary pollutants. ठीक है, so how does acid rain occurs? Generally, what is an acid rain? Guys, all of you must be knowing that acid, the normal, the pH of the normal rain is slightly acidic in nature, right? What is it? The pH of the normal rain is slightly acidic in nature. It is not 7. Otherwise, what is a neutral pH? Neutral pH is 7. But generally, the normal pH does not, normal rain do not have normal pH, neutral pH. It has slightly acidic pH of 5.6 to 6.5. क्या होती है? 5.6 to 6.5 is the pH of the normal rain. And what is known as acid rain? When the pH of the rain goes below 5.6 is known as acid rain. Please do remember this. ये आता है. Okay. Now there might be a question. Why the pH of the normal rain is slightly acidic or is in this range 5.6 to 6.5? Because of the dissolution of carbon dioxide in water. Guys, there is huge amount of carbon dioxide present in the nature. Now it is more than 400 ppm, 405. Now, because abundant amount of carbon dioxide is present in nature, and you know that carbon dioxide also dissolves in water. And so whenever it rains, so what happens? The water get reacted with the carbon dioxide and it forms carbonic acid, which is a weak acid. Kya hota hai ye? This is H2CO3. It is H2CO3. This is a weak acid and this is the reason why ठीक है, why the normal rain pH is slightly acidic. Remember, ये तो आपको पता ही है, carbon dioxide और gases soluble in water. Gases dissolve in water, sorry. Gases do dissolve in water and carbon dioxide also dissolves in water and it is abundantly present in the atmosphere. So whenever there is water in the atmosphere, it gets reacted with the carbon dioxide and it forms carbonic acid. So this is the reason. And this is a weak acid, so this is not much problematic for us. What is problematic? When this pH goes below, right, 5.6, then it'll be a problem. So what is caused by acid? What causes acid rain? Whenever there is formation of sulfuric acid, which is H2SO4, right? Whenever there is formation of sulfuric acid or nitric acid, what is that? HNO3. HNO3 is nitric acid and H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. Whenever there will be high concentration of these two pollutants in nature, And whenever they will precipitate, either in dry form or wet form, that will be known as acid rain. Theek hai? Clear? So now, as you know that these are the secondary pollutants. These are not the primary. There is no definite source which actually emits it. So what happens? These are formed by, this is formed by excess concentration of or excess pollution of sulfur dioxide in nature. When the sulfur dioxide increases too much in the environment, it causes formation of sulfuric acid. I will show you how. And whenever there is huge increase in the nitrogen dioxide concentration or NOx, this will lead to the formation of nitric acid. So majorly, agar hum baat kare, to major sources of acid rain is sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. So, if anyone asks you, what is the source of acid rain? The source of acid rain would be the source of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide, right? So, what is the source of sulfur dioxide? Biggest source of sulfur dioxide is volcanic eruption, guys. One volcanic eruption can emit as much sulfur dioxide as much more than all of the thermal power plants together on Earth. So, basically, natural sources are much more, but otherwise also wherever there is use of coal is the biggest source of sulfur dioxide. So thermal power plants, that is why, because we use thermal power plants, coal is used in large quantity. Biggest source of sulfur dioxide is the burning of coal, and whichever industries uses coal in huge volume, those will be the source of sulfur dioxide. Then nitrogen dioxide. What is the source of nitrogen dioxide? Bataiye. NOx. Whenever we talk about NOx, NOx are what? Yaad rakhna, indeterminate mix of nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Though we have 7 oxides of nitrogen, but these two oxides, nitrogen dioxide and nitric oxide, are considered as air pollutant. ठीक है, air pollutant हम इनको ही बोलेंगे. ठीक है, so what are the source of nitrogen dioxide? Thermal NOx and fuel NOx. Transportation and fuel. Transportation, automobiles are a very big source, and fuel, right, are the source of nitrogen. ठीक है, so these are also the source of acid rain, because they are the reasons for sulfur dioxide production and nitrogen dioxide production. So this is how it works. Let's move further. So what happens basically, let's see what's written here. Basically, NOx, VOCs, yes, VOCs and sulfur dioxide produced during the combustion of coal and petroleum oxidize in air to produce sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid and nitric acid, which get quickly dissolved and wash out to ground as acid rain. ठीक है, ये मैं आपको बता ही चुकी हूँ. Normal rain pH of the, when pH of the rain goes below 5.6, then we will call it as acid rain. So how it works? This is the two-step process. Actually, it's not a one-day process, or it is not a one-step process. The formation of SO2 to sulfate, right? SO4, or we can say that H2SO4 is gradual and it takes days to complete. But finally, aapko reaction to puchenge nahi, you have MCQ type of paper. So you should know
sulfur dioxide then gets reacted with H2O, it'll form H2SO3. Intermediate banega. Then this H2SO3 then will again divide reacted with, will again react with H2O. This will form sulfuric acid. Okay. So this transformation of SO2 to SO4 particle jo hua, it is a gradual process and it takes many days. Okay. So during this time, sulfur pollution may get deposited on land and in water in the form of SO2 and SO4. Sulfate or sulfur dioxide, kisi bhi form mein, this sulfur can get deposited on the land and water. Theek hai? In either form, sulfur can be deposited by precipitation or by dry deposition. Means dry deposition bhi ho sakta, as I have told you, or precipitation ke through bhi. How will it get? It'll get washed out with water, it'll cause precipitation, else there will be dry deposition of it. Theek hai? Clear? So what will happen? So when this sulfur or sulfuric acid or sulfate will reach the soil and water, it will show its harmful effects. Because whenever this sulfur or sulfate or sulfuric acid will decrease the pH of soil as well as water, which is going to create a lot of problems. So how is it going to create a lot of problems on land and water? Let's see. Yahan pe dekhiyega, one point is given. It is also important. What are heavy metals? Heavy metals kya hote hain? Guys, heavy metals are the metals which have high specific gravity. Right? And when we are talking about high specific gravity, that means specific gravity of which is greater than 4.5 to 5. Whenever a metal is having a high specific gravity of more than 4.5 or 5, is known as heavy metal. Now, what is a specific gravity? A specific gravity kuch nahi hota hai. It is the ratio of density of the material. For example, here I'm talking about the metals. Okay? So what is the rho? Rho means density hota hai, pata hai na? What is the density of the metal divided by the density of the material in which that thing is present? Here in, I'm talking about a metal. That means if a metal is present in water, so what will be, what is the density of water? Theek hai? What is the ratio of density of this metal with respect to the density of water? Or if that metal is present in air, so its density in air. Theek hai? So specific gravity's formula is density of that substance or material divided by density of density of water or air in which it is present. Theek hai? Acid kya bola apne? Acid rain gonna cause only when the SOx/NOx reach above the clouds, troposphere. As you mentioned that acid rain takes time, so these gases remain suspended in the troposphere for a long time. Yes, correction. ये होता है sulfate के form में, ये dry form में भी deposition हो सकता है. ये present रहता है when it rains, right? इसीलिए तो कहते हैं कि जब first rain होती है, generally आपने सुना होगा first rain is toxic. A lot of pollutants which are present suspended in the atmosphere will get washed down with it. ठीक है? Whenever it'll come in contact with that, it'll wash out with it. जब water react करेगा sulfur dioxide के साथ, that gases will remain in the troposphere, whole of the troposphere. ऐसा नहीं कि वहाँ वो reach नहीं करेगा. तो when that sulfur dioxide will come in contact with the water, water vapor, here we are talking in terms of, ऐसा नहीं जब वो बारिश होगी तभी होगा. Whenever that will come in contact with the water vapor, right? So it'll form that. So the deposition will be there. ठीक है? Dry form में भी होगा. Dry form may be, it may get deposit on land and water, and even in wet form also it can deposit in land as well as water. Theek hai? Okay, so what will happen, generally heavy metal wala, this point was out of the blue, but it is important. If it is written here, you have to remember it. Theek hai? Now coming back to our topics, Again, this question has come. Guys, you know that alkalinity is caused by carbonates and bicarbonates. And what causes acidity? H positive ion. Increase in the H positive ion concentration causes acidity. Most specific gravity hota hai, ratio density of material. For example, here we were talking about heavy metals. That's what I said. Just say, for example, if I will tell you, calculate the specific gravity of heavy metal in this lake. Theek hai? In this lake. So how will you calculate it? You will calculate the density of that metal. Theek hai? Density of that metal divided by, theek hai, ratio lete hai na, ratio density of water of that lake, hai na? This is a fresh water, hum fresh water ke density le lenge. Density of water. Or if I will ask you, calculate the density of, what will be the specific gravity of lead, hai na? Lead in air. So how will you calculate? You will calculate density of lead. Theek hai? Right. To the ratio. Because generally lead is present in the air. Na? To the ratio of density of air. Clear? So this way we will calculate the specific gravity. So if this will result in value of more than 5 or 4.5. Right, 5 to 4.5 is normal. More than that, if it is 5.5, that means this is a heavy metal. Samajh mein aaya? Clear? Heavy metals, wo metals hote hain whose specific gravity is more than 4.5 to 5. Abhi main wahi bata rahi hoon. If I will consider, jaise ki if I will ask you, calculate whether lead is a heavy metal or not. Right, in air. So lead generally air mein present hai, toh main uska dekh rahi hoon. So the density of lead, we will divide it with the density of air. So by dividing it, if my value will come more than 5, then I will say yes, it is a heavy metal. And if, theek hai, the density will not go above 4.5 or 5, if it will remain less than 4.5, it will be 4 or 3 or something like that. That means the metal is not heavy metal. Theek hai? Heavy metals, and generally, remember one more thing, generally heavy metals also have environmental implications. Theek hai? Environmental implications bhi hote hain. So it is just for your concept. I think every one of you know what heavy metals are. So this was just for your reference. Theek hai? So heavy metals are the metals which have a specific gravity of more than 4.5 to 5. Shall we move further? It's not, isme itna time dene ka koi scene nahi hai. Now let's move to the concept that we are studying. अरे मैं नहीं कह रही हूँ lead is 5.5. मैं ये बोल रही हूँ अगर that means अगर उसका 5.5 से ज़्यादा है तभी हम उसको heavy metal कहेंगे. But you know that guys, you need not to calculate and find out whether it is heavy metal or not. You know that lead, arsenic, zinc, cadmium, mercury, right? We have been telling you these are the heavy metals, right? You know that. Determine नहीं करना है. I just told you how can you determine. अगर उसकी इससे ज़्यादा heavy metal specific gravity है तब आप बोलोगे कि वो heavy metal है. This is a parameter to determine whether a metal is a heavy metal or not. ठीक है? आगे बढ़ें. आ जाओ. Now alkalinity, you know carbonates and bicarbonates again and again. अब now what happens? Whenever there will be acid rain है H2SO4. So this, ये बहुत अच्छे से दिया हुआ है, मैं लिखूंगी नहीं, I'll explain it to you here. See, H2SO4 था, when it will rain, so what will happen? This will increase acidity of soil as well as water. How? Because this will cause 2H plus sign ka increase. H plus H and SO2 negative alag nikal gaya. This is how it is. So when H plus ions will increase in the soil, right, what will they do? When it enters the soil, pehle lake dekh lete hain, chalo. Let's see the lake. Ab kya hua? If it will enter the lake, what will it do? Sabse pehle H positive ion pahuncha. H positive ion will cause one thing. It will reduce the alkalinity and it will increase the acidity because the H plus ions concentration will increase in the lake. So when H plus ion will increase, hydrogen ion will increase, this will cause decrease in the pH. So when pH will decrease, so what will happen? The decrease in the pH will result in the death of sensitive species. ठीक है, sensitive species. उसके बाद क्या होता है? Why sensitive? आपको पता है, because the generally the pH of the lake is 6 to 8. ठीक है, if the concentration of the H positive ions will increase, they will lead to the lowering the pH or acidic conditions, and during acid, under acidic conditions, the fishes or other sensitive species will die. When the fishes and sensitive species will die, this will cause you know, destruction ho raha hai, the healthy ecosystem of lake will get destabilized this way. Theek hai, one thing will happen this way. Dusri cheez kya hoti hai, whenever there is increase in the H positive ion concentration, this leads to the also leads to the increase in the Al plus 3 ion concentration. Aluminium ka ion ka concentration bahut badh jata hai. And do you know that aluminium ion is an acidic cation, guy? Kya hota hai? This aluminium ion is further an acidic cation. To agar ek bar aluminium ion badha, so this will further increase the acidity. And if H plus positive ion badha, this will again increase the concentration of the H positive ion. Ab, H positive ion is very much unhealthy for the aquatic life. Why? This one thing this does, it actually clogs or damages the gill tissues of the fishes. Aluminium ion concentration, what it will does, it will damage the gill tissues of the fishes. So when gills will be damaged, what will happen? Fishes will not be able to breathe properly, respire properly. Jab wo respire nahi kar payenge, to definitely they're going to die. So these, when the fishes will die, so as you know that fishes are very important in maintaining aquatic health. So that means the aquatic ecosystem will, you know, degenerate or will destroy further. Theek hai? Clear? One thing this will happen. The other thing that will happen is, I told you in the sewage treatment plant chapter, if you remember, aluminium ion is having the property of flocculation. It is a very good coagulant, right? Right. So high, I have told you, I guess, higher the charge on the particle, more would be the coagulation property. So Al positive, Al ke upar Al plus 3 charge hota hai. So plus 3 charge is very high. So what will happen? It will attract dirt and all, whatever dirt or turbidity will be present in the lake, it will attract that. Aur usko attract karne ke baad kya karega? So basically, the lake which will be acid rain affected will visually be very having crystal clear water. Why? Because it is a very good coagulant. So whatever dirt or suspended particles present in the water, they will be attracted by the aluminium ions because it is having a good coagulant. It is a good coagulant. It is having flocculation property. So aisi lakes jo hoti hai, they have crystal clear water because of high concentration of aluminium. But such lakes are known as physiologically dead. Kya bolte hai inko? Physiologically dead bolte. Kyunki usme virtually life nahi hogi. Because it has damaged one thing, it has damaged the fishes, it has damaged the sensitive organisms like, you know, diatoms, green algae. So in sabko ye kya karta hai? It actually kills healthy flora and fauna of the water body. Theek hai? Only some sensitive species will remain there, like algae, mosses, or whatever are the tolerant species. Such fishes will not be having the healthy ecosystem, or sorry, such lakes, or such lake will not be called as a healthy water bodies. Theek hai? So this is how it will negatively affect the aquatic life. Agar aap logon mein se kisi ko nahi samajh mein aaya jo bhi maine samjhaya, to please raise your hand. I'll tell you. Do I need to repeat it? I am definitely gonna tell you how this aluminium ion concentration has increased. I'll tell you this, the reason behind that. Except that, if you have any doubt, is it clear? So remember, this aluminium, isliye aapko pata hoga, alum is used in water clean karne mein, water treatment mein alum is used, fitkari jisko bolte hain, aluminium sulfate, because it is having high charge. Higher the charge on an ion, higher will be is its coagulation property or the flocculation property. Which lakes means, I am not getting you. Which lakes, any lake, which is, lakes which have received acid rain. I'm talking about such lakes. What are we studying? We are studying the harmful effects of acid rain on lakes. Lochab is your name, right? What is your question? I'm not getting it. Which lakes means? Whenever acid falls on the feldspar minerals, it destroys the structure of these minerals and which results in the release of aluminium. Samajh mein aaya? This results in the release of aluminium from the soil. Clear? This is how Al plus 3 ions comes in water. And not only in water, in soil also, the concentration of the Al plus 3 ions will increase whenever there is acid rain. Clear? So this is the source. Now, feldspar is the most abundant mineral on the earth crust. So guys, I hope you would have studied this. There is a spelling which is written on the first chapter of the notes that you have. Ram E. ठीक है, इसको ऐसे याद कर लो. Ram E. Ram E क्या होता है? हाँ, नहीं, Ram E is how are rocks formed? Rocks are assemblage of minerals. पता है ना आपको? How do rocks form? Rocks are formed by the assembling the minerals. And how do minerals form? Minerals are formed by the assemblage of elements. ठीक है? Elements क्या हो गए? जैसे कि calcium, carbon, oxygen. These are the elements that we have. And all these things are present on the surface of the earth. Right? These things are present in the soil. Elements. Now these elements will assemble together and they will find minerals. So these three minerals will assemble to form a mineral known as calcium carbonate. Banayega? Ca, carbon and oxygen. These will form calcium carbonate. This is a mineral. And further this will assemble to form a rock. Because minerals always assemble to form rocks. And this will form limestone rock. This is how it goes. So similar is the work. This is a cyclic process, guys. Whenever limestone will break down, weathering of limestone will occur. This will result in the formation of kya banega? Limestone breakdown hoga to. This will result in the formation of calcium carbonate. Mineral release hoga limestone se? Right. Now this further limestone, calcium carbonate will break down further into these elements, calcium, carbon and oxygen. Got it? Clear? So this is a cyclic process. This is how soils are formed. That's why soils are rich in minerals. New soil is rich in minerals. Why? New soil is good. Why? Weathering is a good process because whenever rock will form, rock will break down, this will form new minerals. These new minerals will again break down, which will result in the release of elements. And these elements act as the nutrients for the plants. Theek hai? This is how this process is. Similarly, now we have a mineral known as feldspar. When acid will fall on it, this will cause release of aluminium from this mineral. Theek hai? Breakdown ho jayega. This will break down into the elemental form. Theek hai? So element, not only elemental form, it will result in, it will break down in the ionic form, Al plus 3. Theek hai? So this is the source of aluminium plus 3 ions. This is the reason why the concentration of Al plus 3 ions increases whenever there is acid rain. Clear everyone? I think it's more time now. Let's stop here. We will study the, you know, effects on soil tomorrow in the next class. Clear yahan pe sabko? Please do read once yourself as well. Then we will do it in the next class. That's all for tonight.